excitement simply because the United States, in quite a surprise, has made it to the quarterfinals. Now, if you have been following track cycling, and you hear me say it's quite a surprise, you'd say, well, Bill Fleming doesn't know what he's talking about. They were supposed to be there. But an unusual set of circumstances has allowed the Americans to be to the quarterfinals. In their qualifying run, to be one of the best eight teams as far as time is concerned, the United States had a mishap. In the first 50 meters, Pat McDonald had his front wheel loosened, and he spilled on the track. Normally, you'd expect a restart with all four men, but the commissars of cycling decided that that mechanical failure was not due to anything with the equipment. It was simply negligence on the United States team's part. They didn't tighten the wheel, so they eliminated McDonough, and the United States had to qualify with three men. Then, 3.5 laps from the finish line, with those three men, Brent Emery, Leonard Nitz, and Steve Haig, they had a mishap on the backstretch where they spilled. So they had to restart and do it all over again, and still came back and qualified fifth fastest. It's really one of the outstanding stories that we've had here at the Velodrome. And right now, the United States with Emery, Haig, McDonough, and Nitz will face Denmark with Frost, Markussen, Pedersen, and Sorensen. The rules are simple. It is simply a race of endurance and speed. The United States team will try to pass the Danes. If they do, they would eliminate them, and vice versa, of course. And we will have the winner here going on to the semifinals. Eric Heiden?
Well, the U.S. has had two hard rides, essentially, to get to this point when you look at the fact that they were almost 1 kilometer from the finish of the first qualifying round when they had that accident. They had to go out and do it again. And now they're starting really their third ride of the day, and you wonder just how much that's going to cost them. With three guys, Emery was hurting in the first ride. Now he's back out here. We also have McDonough. He was the guy who he had the mechanical failure first off. So now we got four riders. Hopefully things will go smooth. But the Danish team, very strong team. They have a rider named Markussen, probably the strongest guy out here. Maybe with a strong rider, though, they're going to have to be careful, because a lot of times a strong rider will go to the front and just shatter the whole group. So it's important that the teams stay together, all four riders. You have to finish with three riders. That's the important thing to remember.
Now, they start on opposite sides of the track, and if you've been with us for the individual pursuit, you know that there are certain markings on this track, and we will show them to you electronically that will enable you to see where they are. Now, see that the yellow marks there? The team that crosses that first is the team out in front. Right now, the United States is 0.03 seconds behind, 0.3.
Watch the rider in front. He's working very hard. The riders behind are sitting in his draft. As they come to the corner, he swings up the track. There you can see the American rider swings up the track, comes down, takes the last position, able to relax a little bit, use that draft. Again, another rider at the front. They hit the corner. He swings up, lets another rider take over, because when you're sitting behind at second, third, and fourth place, you aren't working at all as hard.
That's Steve Haig, incidentally, out in front of the United States. And we noticed that his left wrist has been bandaged as a result of that accident on the backstretch. Leonard Harvey Nitz has taken it over, and the United States is 0.04 seconds behind.
Both teams are looking very good right now. If you take a look at the U.S. riders' bicycles, you notice that they have that solid rear wheel. Helps a lot. They figure that having a solid rear wheel, no spokes, you can take off anywhere from 1 second to 3 seconds a kilometer.
Frost, Markussen, Pedersen, and Sorensen for the Danes. Haig, Nitz, McDonough, and Emery for the United States. The United States is 0.71 behind, and they will have seven laps to go. Haig is now in the front position, and he swings out after every half lap. Now you can see that electronic graphic, which shows you the United States has fallen 0.89 seconds behind.
As we get farther into this race, don't be surprised when you see one rider drop off the pace and actually come off the track. It's important to remember that it's the third rider from each team that crosses the finish line that gets the time for the entire team. So you want to stay close together. You don't want to blow anybody off. You got to finish with three riders.
Denmark was sixth in the world championship in 83, and the best the United States has ever finished in team pursuit was sixth in 1981. Now the United States team has whittled it down to 0.68, so they're putting on a spurt.
The U.S. team throughout this entire race is in very close contact with the coach. The coach has a little transmitter, and each rider has a little microphone, or not microphone, little headphone in their ear so they can hear the coach telling them instructions the entire race.
That's McDonough. Pat McDonough is now leading for the Americans. That's Emery behind him, then Hagen Nitz. McDonough swings out. Emery will take over.
Emery's looking very strong. I suspect that he would be the weak link in this ride.
Now look at this, 0.34. The United States team is picking up the pace. When they come by the next time, it'll be three laps to go.
Ooh, you can see Emery starting to come off the back. The U.S. is down to three riders now.
Haig is in the lead. Emery out. Now the United States has taken the lead. Denmark has fallen 4/10 behind, but the U.S. is down to three riders. The question is, do they have the stamina to go? It'll be two laps to go when they go to the backstretch. They'll swing into the turn, go down the backstretch, and the sign will be flashed to them. Two laps to go. Now the United States is 37 hundredths behind. It's back and forth. The Danes are in front. That might be expected because of the three-man ride.
But the U.S. team is looking very strong, and even though they're down to three guys, remember, they have Steve Haig and Harvey Nitz, both very good pursuers. Haig yesterday, first place medal, Nitz third place, so.
That's Nitz with one lap to go.
0.08 of a second.
That's all they're behind, and you've got two of the best sprinters in the United States right there. And don't forget, Steve Haig is the gold medalist in the 4,000-meter individual pursuit. Half a lap to go, the United States is 0.14 behind. Can they do it? Watch the screen carefully. Whoever crosses that line first will win it. It is Denmark, I believe. No, the United States beats them by 0.01 of a second.
Look at Eddie B, the U.S. coach. Is he happy now? The U.S. has had really three unbelievable rides to get to this point.
It looked for a second as if Denmark had crossed that line just eyeballing it across the track, but the electronic timer picked it up in the closest possible margin. 1/100th of a second.
The U.S. has got to be very happy. They've come a long ways to get to this point. A lot of hard rides to beat one of the strongest teams, the Danish team.
Oh, but how about how they did it and how they got to the quarterfinals? I think all we have to do is just sit back in absolute awe of this team in terms of the courageous performance today. I don't think I've ever seen anything like it. And it looked at one point when they were 0.89 of a second behind as if they might have had a problem. But as you saw, they came from behind and they held on to win it by the absolute smallest margin that is possible in track cycling, 1/100th of a second.
But I lie to you, I told you it was exciting. It really is something. We've come so far in cycling since 76 in Montreal. It really is fascinating. That, of course, was a quarterfinal race. The semifinals and the finals of team pursuit competition will be coming up later today, and that promises the same kind of excitement. Okay, we're